Happening, guys. AJ here, Team Overkill. Just bringing you guys another video. I want to do a war recap so far. War ended. We didn't do too well. 48-63. We got smashed. We went up against. They had a lot of wins. Plus, they're a level 9 clan. So, but anyways, I'm going to show you guys some of this recap, and I want to talk to you guys about the UFC. Event this weekend, and you guys know the infamous Mr. Conor McGregor versus Nate Diaz. Just to let you guys know on that end, it's gonna be a very interesting fight. As you actually take a look at it, you look in depth. You guys know Conor McGregor; he has a different fighting style. It's unique. It looks to me his style is like karate, taekwondo. A little bit, his movements almost look like a savate style movement too, that way he bounced back and forth. On the other hand, you have Nate Diaz. He's a boxer, and he's a ground guy. He's black belt in Brazilian jiu-jitsu under the Gracie Academy, and like what I said, he's a good fighter as well, so don't get me wrong, but I think for a fact that Conor's gonna win this fight. One detail is that if you look, it's kind of a last minute replacement, because since Rafael Dos Anjos had an injury on his foot, it looked like he broke his foot. On the picture, if you guys look on Instagram, he posted up there, and it looks pretty bad. But of course, Conor and his antics, and he's a fight promoter. As you guys could tell, as the video, I put the clip in there. So that way you guys could hear some of his ranting and raving. And let me tell you guys, man, this guy, he knows how to sell fights. And not only he knows how to sell the fight, but he also gets into the opponent's head. If you guys seen his last fight against Aldo, man, I mean, literally, mental warfare. It's not just physical for Conor when you're going up against him. You're actually going against him mentally too, because, he kind of prepares you. For your defeat already. He's kind of like, kind of pushing you in there for that defeat, and he's already beating you at your own mindset. So it kind of takes over your mental game and your thought. It manifests. So you're pretty much already stepping into a ring. You're being defeated already, and you already know what the outcome. And, he does a really good job getting into the opponent's head, too. Just like what I said, Nate Diaz, you can't take away nothing from him. He's a great fighter. He has great hand skills. He's a good boxer. And you guys know his brother as well. He's pretty much in the pedigree of the fighting family. Like I said, they're very proficient in boxing. And they're both, both brothers are black belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu as well. But like I said, I think for him taking this fight on short notice, that's going to kind of hinder his performance, and I think it's going to end up giving Conor the win. And Conor is very precise, when he throws his punches and his kicks, and his style is like so different, and no one that could actually mimic his style. So it's kind of hard finding a training partner for Nate Diaz to mimic that style, because like I said, Conor McGregor is a unique fighter, and no one has figured him out yet. And just The whole fact is that he gets into your head, and the mental game takes over. And like what I said, even Nate Diaz, he does a good job of mental warfare and promoting the fights. But it's going to be a very interesting match. And if it remains standing up, Conor's going to win. If this gets down to the ground, Nate Diaz have a really good chance of beating Conor McGregor. But I have it, Conor's going to win this fight hands down. I just think, Conor McGregor is going to be too fast and elusive for, Nate, because, Nate likes to stay in the pocket and exchange. and he keeps moving forward. There's no angles that, you know, he does. He doesn't move really well in angles, and, you know, he's a straight-up brawler, you know, and he does a really good job. Like I said, he has good hand skills. Can't take that away from him. But anyways, just listen to some of the antics, and just watch what they say, and just how watch Conor McGregor promotes the fight. And this guy's funny. He makes me laugh. And like I said, he brings you to the fight. You know, you don't bring yourself to the fight. You want to see this guy. You know, he's a showmanship. Plus, it's the way how he promotes. Even Nate Diaz, you got to give him credit too. He promotes fight as well. And like I said, you know, I just want to see how Conor, you know, fares well against like taller and bigger opponents. And this is going to be a good test for him. You know, like I said, he could have fought like tougher opponents, but I think this was a good pick for him to start off at the, you know, well, it's supposed to be at 155, but they end up fighting at a 170. Since there were some weight issues, but allegedly, so I don't know. So, but anyways, you know, hopefully you guys like the video. Please like and subscribe. You know, this is something new. This is something different from just regular Clash of Clans channel. So I'm going to be reviewing other stuff as well. So, you know, like I said, you know, if you guys Clash.